we are going to discuss about limitations of octet rule. But basically, to understand this, we know what is meant by octet rule. According to Lewis, the scientist, any atom on gaining octet configuration, it is said to be stable. For example, we know sodium positive octet configuration, it is complete. Chlorine Cl minus radical, that is also octet configuration complete. We know all those states where on completing octet rule, stability is achieved because completely filled outermost orbital they are obtaining. So outermost shell is completely filled, so highly stable octet complete. So octet rule means for stability. So that was a basic. If octet rule is achieved, stable. So that was only concept behind octet rule. Now there are certain limitations. Can this octet rule be said for the whole chemistry? No. You cannot apply this rule to explain stability of all the compounds. There are various, so many limitations of this octet rule. So what are these limitations? First limitation is incomplete octet. Certain compounds, without even completing octet rule for the elements, they form stable compounds. For example, beryllium chloride. Beryllium chloride, the structure of beryllium chloride is beryllium connected to chlorine and here also connected to chlorine. Here, when we analyze this compound, chlorine has, you know, total 8 electrons in the overall, including the sharing, I'm telling. So without sharing, it was supposed to have 7 electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 1 electron here sharing. With beryllium 1 electron, so total it becomes 8 for chlorine. So chlorine 8, here also chlorine it is 8. Chlorine stable, but what about beryllium? Beryllium does not have 8 electron here. Beryllium has how many? 1, 2. This beryllium is having sharing with how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. So only here 2 electron for beryllium and here also 2 electron for beryllium. So on adding, you will be getting 4 electron for beryllium. So by having 4 electron for beryllium, this compound is highly stable. That means beryllium is stable. Chlorine is stable. Everything is stable. So this octet rule, according to this octet rule, it is supposed to be unstable, but that is wrong. So it is stable. So that is a limitation of octet rule. It cannot explain the stability of incomplete octet forming compounds such as beryllium chloride. Okay, so this is the first thing. Beryllium chloride is an example that shows the limitation of octet rule. That is incomplete octet. Without even completing the octet, the compound forms stable. Okay, compound is stable. Second is expanded octet. Our aim for octet rule, what was it? 8 electron percent being stable. That is octet. So here, in expanded octet, expanded octet. In expanded octet, let's consider a compound SF6. Sulfur hexafluoride. Sulfur hexafluoride. In this compound, if we are drawing the structure of it, we can see around the sulfur, 6 fluorine are bonding, covalent bond only, okay? So 6 fluorines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, they are connected by fluorine. This is a stable compound. So there is nothing unstable in this, it is stable, okay? So if we are seeing in the central sulfur, how many electrons is present in the covalent bond? In the sulfur, 2 electrons from this, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So 12 electrons around sulfur. Sulfur. So sulfur is violating the octet rule. That is, 8 was only necessary to become stable. But it is 7, 12. So octet rule is, according to octet rule, it was supposed to be unstable. But that is wrong. It is highly stable. This is very stable. Sulfur hexafluoride is very stable and it is very resistant to hydrolysis also. So you can see limitation of octet rule. According to that octet rule, we cannot explain stability here, but this is stable. So this is expanded octet forming compounds are violating octet rule. Still they are stable, indicating limitation of the octet rule. The law has limitations. Now the third important limitation of octet rule, that is odd electron molecule. So what is meant by odd electron? Odd electron means, we know, odd numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7, like that. So here, if one electron is coming excess, it's odd electron. Similarly, let's consider the third, that is odd electron molecule or compound. CPD, I'm just showing compound, okay? Odd electron compound. Let's see NO. NO is a compound. We know nitrogen dioxide is NO2. Similarly, nitrogen monoxide is NO. So this compound, when we are drawing the structure, we know nitrogen has how many electron? How many? Nitrogen atomic number is how much? Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, 7. So it will be 2, 5. K shell, N shell. So N shell 5 electron. So 5 electron in the outermost shell. So we can write it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like this. Whereas oxygen, we know it is atomic number 8. So it will be having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electron. So let's show the bonding. I'm just showing this 2 electron here, okay? Both, anyway, you can show it's not a problem. So nitrogen compound forming. 1 electron, 2, like this. This is nitrogen. And oxygen is also forming like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if you are considering the oxygen, this forms a double bond over here. Double bond formation takes place. So oxygen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oxygen octetrule, okay, stable. But what about the nitrogen? The overall compound is stable. That we know. That is experimentally also proved that it is very stable. NO is stable. So you see, in this compound NO, you can see nitrogen has how many electrons right now after sharing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 only. 7 electron only present. This is odd electron. 1, 3, 5, 7. So it's odd. Octet rule incomplete. Nitrogen did not attain octet rule. So, but the compound is stable. Moreover, you can see lone pair of electron is always 2, 2. 2, 2 each. Here only one electron. This is an odd electron. One electron is staying there. If one more was there, then only it was supposed to be stable according to octet rule. But the compound is already stable. So octet rule has a limitation. It could not explain the stability of such odd electron compounds or odd electron molecules. So this was one of the limitation of octet rule. So let's discuss the next limitation of octet rule. We cannot call octet rule as universal rule because if there are limitations, we cannot apply it everywhere. Then how it can be universal rule? It is not possible, okay? But it can be used to explain some compounds only, okay? Then it cannot explain geometry of compound. In your grade 10, you had studied CH4 is methane. The structure of methane which you did according to octet rule completion in grade 10 was like this. According to octet rule, that rule told that total 8 electrons should be there, stable, carbon stable. Okay, hydrogen anyway 2 electron only maximum possible, that's exceptional stability. So this, according to octet rule, this was what we studied. We did not care much about how the shape was. But the structure of the methane is not like this. This is wrong structure. The shape or the geometry of methane is not like that. It is carbon like this. Here, there's a particular angle that we will study when we study detail about bonding. So this is the structure of methane. It is not like this. It is like this. So that could not be explained by octet rule. Did not talk anything about shape and geometry. So that is why octet rule has another limitation. It did not discuss anything about the geometry of the compound. Fifth limitation of octet rule. We know noble gases. What are the noble gases? Fifth, we are writing. Could not explain why some noble gas form compound. According to octet rule, we know that noble gases helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, all of these have 8 electrons in its outermost shell. So helium neon I can represent it as 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Similarly, xenon also I am representing. Any all the things you can represent like this. 8. Octet rule already complete. Then, this is stable. It don't need to form compound. Why chemicals form compound? To gain stability. According to octet rule, this is already stable. So why it should form compound? But no, it is actually forming variety of compounds. XCF4, XCF6, XCF2, XCOF4, XCO2F2, XCO3, so many compounds. Xenon forms so many compounds like this. This could not be explained by octet rule. Why a stable noble gas should form compound? According to octet rule, it is nonsense. But no, that's a limitation of octet rule. It could not explain all this concept. So that's a limitation. Even krypton can form some chlorides and fluorides. Okay. Krypton can form some chlorides under specific conditions. Okay. Radon is radioactive. So we are not discussing much about it. So this is also a fact that is true but cannot be explained by octet rule. So it's a limitation of octet rule. So main 5 limitations of octet rule we have discussed. And it may be asked in your examination also. And I hope you understood. Please like, share and subscribe.